Hello and welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dirk Winkelhardt and I will present you the enhancement of MacPepDB. MacPepDB is a SQL database containing the triptych in silico digest of all proteins contained by UniProt in April 2020. The peptides have a length of 6 to 50 amino acids with a maximum of 2 miscleavages. Currently, MacPepDB runs on a single server, offering 112 cores, 754 GB of RAM and 8 TB RAID 5 SSD storage with a maximum read performance of 67 MB per second. Here you can see a simple query to MacPepDB for a mass of 859.49 Dalton and a tolerance of plus minus 5 ppm. Let's make this query more exciting with two post-translational modifications. The variable oxidation of M and the static carbaminomethylation of C, and we allow up to 3 variable modifications per peptide. Now we have to consider the impact of all combinations of the two modifications on our targeted mass. For the first combination, we have to make sure no C is contained in the peptide sequences, because each C would increase our mass by 57 Dalton. The next combination will allow exactly one C in the peptide sequence, but decreases the quarried mass by one carbaminomethylation of C to match our targeted mass again. Because the oxidation of M is variable, it can be ignored for the first combinations. In the later combinations, we have to consider it, so we get peptides with at least 1, 2, 3 M's to match our targeted mass again. The finished query contains 18 mass modifications combinations. The question is, which impact have these queries on MacPepDB? A simple query would read only a small block from the SSD storage. It actually returns 57,000 peptides, which have a raw size of around 12 MB, which is fine because it is below the server's read limit. The query with the post-translational modifications, on the other hand, reads multiple blocks from the SSD storage and therefore returns a lot more data. When more clients using MacPepDB, each of them executing queries with post-translational modifications, even more blocks are read in parallel. Eventually, this leads to the full occupation of our storage I/O capacity. With MacPepDB growing with every UniProt release and more users using MacPepDB, this problem gets much worse, causes query to run several minutes to complete. Of course, PostgreSQL uses the RAM to cache read data for faster access, but due to the unpredictability of the query, and with increasing numbers of clients, the cache has to be rebuilt continuously, losing its advantage. The solution is quite simple. We rebuild MacPepDB on a distributed database. This has multiple advantages. First, each server can be smaller in hardware than the original one. Second, each server must contain only a small chunk of the overall data, and the total read performance will be increased with each server added to the database. Each client will then read data from multiple servers in parallel, allowing the distribution of read operations on multiple servers. Currently, we pursue two very different solutions. First, an extension to PostgreSQL called CTUS. Because PostgreSQL is the current basis for MacPepDB, only slight modifications are necessary to build MacPepDB with CTUS. On the other hand, we have Cassandra, which is a NoSQL key value store. To build MacPepDB with Cassandra, a rewrite of code is necessary because Cassandra uses its own query language called CQL and lacks some SQL features, like for example foreign keys. Besides the changes in the codebase of MacPepDB, the main challenge lies in the optimal distribution of the data, so the load is evenly distributed on each server. For the data distribution, the database uses one of the table columns as distribution key, which has to be chosen by the developer. A good distribution key divides the data in multiple chunks without being so diverse that thousands of really small chunks will be created by the database. An example for an unsuitable distribution key is a peptide mass. With around 178 million distinct masses, this key is so diverse that CTUS will rebalance the chunks continuously during the database build in the attempt to find an optimal distribution. This slows the build massively down. In the end, it needs more than 30 days, while the current build on the original server needs only 11 to 12 days. Using the frequency of peptide masses from the current MacPepDB, it is possible to create a less diverse distribution key by distributing the peptides evenly on 100 bins, where the bin boundaries are the peptide masses. After the binning is complete, the bin index can be used as a less diverse distribution key. The distribution key can then simply be looked up by the peptide mask. It is also possible to recalculate it with more or less spins and changes later in the database to rebalance the peptides. I would like to thank Julian Uschkereit, Katrin Markus and Martin Eisenacher to entrust me with this exciting project.